the ICT sector can help the whole world to reduce 20% of the global carbon emission.
Our survey data shows that worldwide, about 75% of organizations think that sustainability or ESG is very important to the enterprise value of their organization.
Hello and welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us at Taiwan Business and Trade Show webinar for ICT Industry. My name is Lee and I'm the project manager at Tytra. I'm so delighted to be your host today. While many countries' economies have suffered from COVID-19, Taiwan remained relatively strong. In fact, Taiwan's economy, dominated by ICT, has benefited from the strong demand for semiconductors during the pandemic. In recent years, ESG has been one of the most discussed topics in the ICT industry. To achieve corporate sustainability, ESG is not just a buzzword, but a commitment. Tech giants and big brands have committed to achieving net zero carbon emission by 2050. Nowadays, semiconductors and hardware companies are also enablers of decarbonization in the face of a green economy transformation. Taiwan is a global leader in the ICT industry. Every year, numerous renowned exhibitions are held in Taiwan. Some of them include Smart City Summit and Expo, GTI Asia Taipei Expo, Touch Taiwan, Secutech, and Computex. Today's webinar will walk you through ESG in the ICT industry as well as these popular trade shows. This seminar consists of three parts. First, we have guest speakers from KPMG and IDC to share ESG trends and insights, followed by companies addressing their ESG practices. Last but not least, we would like to invite you to join us for some of the exhibition highlights. Without further delay, first, we are honored to have Dr. Niven Huang, KPMG Aspect ESG leader and regional leader of KPMG Sustainability Services in Asia Pacific, as well as managing director as KPMG Sustainability Consulting Corporate in Taiwan. Since 2015, Dr. Huang has been on the jury panel of the Asia Responsible Entrepreneurship Awards. He is a pioneer for promoting CSR, sustainability reporting, SRI, corporate sustainability strategy, and carbon management in Taiwan. Let's welcome Niven.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Niven Huang. Currently, I am the KPMG Aspect ESG leader. Today is my pleasure and an honor to be invited by Tytra to share my perspective in Taiwan Business and Trade Show webinar for ICT industries. In the last 2 years, all of us has already witnessed the impact caused by COVID-19. We are still struggling, even 2 years already passed. During the last 2 years, I think everybody has been already suffer from the lockdown, reopen and re-lockdown and big scale lockdown because of the infectious disease. And everybody also witnessed the chain reaction caused by COVID-19 all over the world. It is so obvious for everybody to understand if we do not have a safe and healthy society, robust ecosystem, it is not possible for us to make a prosperous economy. So we always emphasize no E environmental, no S, no social, no prosperity. So now a lot of ICT industry and some of the technical giant, they have been trying to make themselves in a different leading and disruptive innovative business strategies that is strongly related to ESG sustainability strategy. I call it digitalization and electrification with ESG purpose. Based on the trust barometer, global survey by Adamant, a lot of opinion leaders has already represented their perspective. They regard business as the most competent and ethical stakeholder in our society from now on to support, to facilitate, to enable our daily life and the whole society to move to a much more sustainable future. We must do something very different by 2040, by 2030, and now, 2022. The World Economic Forum has already called for a lot of attention that we gotta transfer our existing economy to stakeholder capitalism. What does that mean? In the past business model, the business is just to make money to benefit themselves, to benefit the consumer, but we pay little attention to the stakeholders along the value chain, including the employee, the labor, the supplier, the environmental and ecosystem. So we gotta redefine our value, not just on the economic value, we gotta also care about the environmental value and social value. What kind of consequences we would like to achieve by using a much more sustainable long-term reason business model? Triple bottom lines. We would like to achieve the environmental bottom line, social bottom line, and of course the most important is traditional economic bottom line. If we want to survive because of the climate change, by facing the carbon constraint age, we must dedicate ourselves to do our best to reduce the carbon emission to net zero. How can we do that? We gotta adopt a lot of carbon management practices, no matter that is low cost, no cost, or significant low carbon investment, including technology R&D, and also to change the linear economy ICT sector to circular ICT sector. If we cannot reduce the carbon emission to net to zero, then we gotta also leverage the carbon offsetting mechanism to achieve net zero and carbon neutral. Taiwan in the last 3-4 decades, we are the important, the vital key role worldwide to supply the digital solution. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic and the climate change, it is so obvious that Taiwan ICT sector well dedicated themselves to move forward the solution R&D to become the key player to enable the whole society to transform from the fossil fuel economy to the low carbon, even the net zero low carbon future. By smarter ICT application, the ICT sector can help the whole world to reduce 20% of the global carbon emission. By smarter ICT application, then we can enable 2.5 extra global population to join the knowledge economy. And because of this kind of contribution, every year by 2030, then we can jointly generate every year $11 trillion revenue. So that is a juicy market. So we need to facilitate, to encourage, to drive the worldwide ICT to become much more smarter, to provide the integrated digital solution to enable the whole world to transform to the greener, to sustainable, to low carbon future. How we gotta do that? Because we are facing a resource constraints age, so we need to maximize utilization of our existing resources, including plastic, the general metal, and also scarce metal, and a lot of different kind of material to be used in the smarter ICT devices. How can we move forward to achieve the circular economy? Now the worldwide, the global leading business organization has to create a new alliance for the circular electronics. Then they have already made the new circular electronic roadmap and try to define the several very important key steps for build up the institutional capacity by engaging the multi-stakeholder together to move from the circular electronic design and try to drive the demand for the circular product, circular technology, and circular service. And we're gonna also need to promote and advocate the responsible electronics business model. We also need to build up a very good reverse logistics and also try to enhance the used electronic products collection rate for falling out material resource recycling. So all of this kind of a loop and roadmap, it is very important, the R&D. The electronic product design and manufacturing should move to the new era because of low carbon and circularity. So I would like to wrap up. Now, the total ICT sector, no matter where you are, Taiwan ICT sector will play a very important catalyst, try to facilitate and enable the whole electronic industry value chain to deliver the positive impact to environmental and ecosystem, to the whole society, and also prosperous economy development. So ICT is a key to build better, greener, sustainable, and inclusive. It is not an easy journey, but if everybody change, the global ICT change, Taiwan ICT change, then we can move from the short-term reason to the long-term reason. We can move the business model just only benefit the shareholder value. Now we can move to another new era to benefit all of the multi-stakeholder, no matter where you are. So I think that we are looking for a sustainable future for ourselves, for our coming generation. Thank you very much for your listening.
Thanks, Niven, for sharing your insights. A resilient future lies in digitalization as well as electrification. With ESG, bearing in mind the ICT industry is the solution provider for systematic transformation. ICT is leading net zero strategy roadmap and the key to building a better, greener, and more sustainable future. Next, we will hand the floor over to our guest from IDC, Bjorn Stengel, Global Sustainability Research and Practice Lead of Sustainable Strategies and Technologies. Bjorn is IDC's Global Sustainability Research Lead. His research focuses on how environmental, social, governance topics impact and shape business strategies and technology usage. Let's welcome Bjorn.
Hi. First of all, I would like to thank Taitra for their invitation to this Taiwan Business and Trade Show webinar on the ICT industry. I'm here to present to you IDC's view on how corporate sustainability and ESG have been evolving over the past years and how it's been shaping the industry. The way in which companies approach sustainability has been changing a lot just over the past 12 or 18 months. In the past, corporate sustainability was mainly seen as a way of doing good, basically a cost to the business for doing something that helps communities or the environment, but without looking at the real impact that these initiatives have. Today, most organizations around the world have adopted more of an ESG-driven approach that looks at the direct business impact that environmental, social, and governance topics have on the organization and how the organization responds to those issues. In fact, our survey data shows that worldwide, about 75% of organizations think that sustainability or ESG is very important to the enterprise value of their organization. That number is up from 48% in 2020. This shows that today, sustainability is more than just doing good. A strong performance on their most material ESG issues helps companies improve their operational and financial performance, their brand reputation and competitiveness, and lower their risks. In order to put ESG into action, organizations need to be able to quantify their ESG performance by using commonly accepted metrics and KPIs that cover all relevant or material ESG issues. These issues can be environmental topics, greenhouse gas emissions, water usage, etc., but also social and human capital topics such as diversity, equity, and inclusion, data security and privacy, human rights, and so on. Organizations increasingly look at technology vendors to help them achieve their sustainability goals. They look at ICT and other vendors to provide technology that enables sustainable transformation. And they look at vendors in different ways. Let's take the example of a provider of cloud-based software. The first thing a technology buyer would probably do is to find out what ESG-specific functionality that software has. Can it help capture and curate ESG data? Can it help report that data to external parties using ESG reporting standards and frameworks? More and more buyers are also looking to use ESG information internally to help their internal stakeholders leverage ESG information to improve internal operations. And since we're talking about internal stakeholders, the group of personas and functions that have responsibilities and budgets for sustainability-related purchasing decisions is also broadening. In the past, sustainability was primarily a communications or PR topic for most companies. In our recent surveys, however, we found that today sustainability and ESG is primarily a CEO or CFO level topic, which really shows the strategic importance. There are a number of other LOB and IT functions that were also pretty high up on that list, like the chief HR officer, the chief supply chain officer, the chief information and chief innovation officer. All of these personas are now included in the corporate sustainability processes and are looking for software solutions that can help them manage their part of the sustainability journey. Another important aspect in the case of cloud-based software solution is the sustainability of the cloud itself. Technology buyers are making their buying decisions by also looking at the energy savings that they can get by switching to a specific cloud provider, by the carbon footprint that that provider has, and so on. And lastly, they're also looking at how that vendor is managing its internal sustainability process and how that is being tied into the product story. Leading by example is an important element for demonstrating real commitment to sustainability. And we see in our surveys that buyers value that in their decision-making process. On the IT equipment side, we see IT buyers tying their procurement and IT purchasing decisions closely to sustainability, and they assess how those decisions can help them achieve their sustainability goals, both from an operational efficiency and cost perspective, but also in regards to their brand perception. IT planning processes are heavily influenced by circular economy considerations. According to our recent surveys, IT buyers find it important that IT equipment is recyclable at the end of its life in an effort to reduce e-waste, and their IT purchasing decisions reflect that. This means that IT vendors need to be able to convey the sustainability-related impact that their solutions have for the clients and how they can directly impact their clients' sustainability efforts. Quantifying the sustainability-related business value of IT solutions has become really important, and it will be a critical competitive differentiator. In many cases, that can involve the help of professional services firms, either through an external consulting firm or through the services arm of an IT vendor. Even though most organizations recognize the importance of ESG and they are already facing pressure from many different external stakeholders, investors, regulators, suppliers, employees, to just name a few, the overall maturity levels are still relatively low. From an IDC perspective, we look at sustainability directly in the context of digital transformation and think that sustainable and digital transformation need to go hand in hand. IT vendors need to demonstrate how they can help clients with both aspects of transformation, and technology will be critical for clients to reach their ambitious ESG goals. With that, I would like to thank you for your time and your interest in this important topic.
Thanks, Bjorn, for the insightful sharing. After learning these inspiring thoughts and trends on ESG, let's dive a little further and move on to our next topic. Now let's welcome our partners to share their ESG practices. First is Acer on their project Earthian and its commitment on carbon reduction. Earthian is Acer's mission to tackle the environmental challenges through innovative and integrated solutions. Jason Chen, Acer's chairman and chief executive officer, will share their actions in their commitment at RE100. Let's welcome Jason.
Hi, today I would like to spend a couple minutes to talk about Acer's actions and our commitments on RE100. To start with, we have strong belief on it's everybody, every company's responsibility to make sure that we do the right thing for a greener environment, a better Earth. At this moment when we are speaking, Acer Corporation is used up to more than 44% renewable energy, and we have committed by 2035, the number will go up to 100, and therefore RE100 by 2035. And we believe it's more than just one company. We need to include more stakeholders, and therefore we launched the Earthian campaign to include our employees and our suppliers. We have been doing CDP for two-tier supply chain, and we'll expand it to three tiers in 2022. At the same time, we have co-founded Taiwan Climate Alliance to include more ICT companies locally in Taiwan to make sure that collectively we do the right thing for climate change, for green environment, and for renewable energy.
Project Humanity wants to create a green mindset among employees through activities and campaigns.
Project Humanity is a way to share my green lifestyle.
The real change is coming when every person is making their conscious choice.
It's a way for Acer to help employees embrace green initiative and sustainable actions.
Acer has been keeping it actively through these years that we are making our green mark all around the industry.
A great opportunity to make a new path to the sustainable future.
The clear message to everyone that Acer supports environmental sustainability.
Do the right thing.
Make a positive impact on the world.
Project Humanity helps us each take responsibility for leaving the planet in better condition for the next generation.
Acer is a leading brand. We can be the leader in green solutions.
Because change has to start somewhere.
Project Humanity is doing our part for the future.
Every decision counts.
Thank you, Jason, for sharing the perspective. Green product design can have a significant impact on the Earth. Acer's corporate commitment is to build a resilient company for a sustainable future. Moving on is Qualcomm on the experience in enabling partners with green energy. ST Liu, Vice President and President of Qualcomm Taiwan and Southeast Asia, will share their practices and commitment on ESG. Let's welcome ST.
As the world's leading wireless technology innovator and a global company committed to sustainability, Qualcomm sees technology as a critical lever addressing some of the world's most pressing problems. We see climate change and the protection of natural resources as key area of our corporate strategy. We believe 5G plays a transformative and important role ushering in a more sustainable future. 5G, with its ultra-low latency and extreme reliability, usher in and enable new applications and services, anything from the measuring of water consumption in real time to helping in the reduction of greenhouse gas emission. 5G will continue to bring positive impacts to society, firms, industry all over the world for many, many years to come. Taking the USA as an example, we see as 5G deployment continues, a saving of more than 370 million metric tons of GHG emission in 2025, a saving of more than 410 billion gallons of water annually, and a 20% fuel efficiency improvement. These were data presented last year in a report by Qualcomm. And for you to find out more about 5G and its role in sustainability, please check out our website. As mobile technologies continue to benefit people, society, everywhere in the world, it is important for us to collaborate with the key stakeholders to foster sustainability. The best example is the Qualcomm Taiwan Sustainability Collaboration Project. It is Qualcomm's first global collaboration with an indirect supplier to promote renewable energy or the development of renewable energy. And we believe we will achieve significant saving in electricity as well as in the reduction of CO2 emission. Through this collaboration, we hope to build a strong foundation in promoting and encouraging transitioning to renewable energy here in Taiwan and everywhere else in the world. In Taiwan, strides have been made, achievements have been made, and we want to share that and amplify them throughout the world. Sustainability is a crucial priority globally, and Qualcomm shares that goal. In fact, Qualcomm has been a member of the Responsible Business Alliance for many years. Critical and immediate decisions have to be made to cope with the challenges on climate change. And Qualcomm will continue to cooperate with our partners and customers in the future in support of our 2030 vision of an increased sustainability and the transparent management of climate and water impact throughout our value chain. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ST, for your insights. Qualcomm's sustainability project connects Taiwan's suppliers and increases the value of the supply chain management in a view of climate and water. We bet you can't wait to learn more about implementing ESG in your business and how the ICT industry can be solution providers. The mice industry in Asia experienced a challenging time from 2020 to 2021. However, according to WFI, the trade show industry will recover gradually. In a nutshell, trade shows are expected to return soon. At the end of today's webinar, I would like to share some highlights from Taiwan's top technology trade shows. Smart City Summit and Expo, a global smart city networking platform. GTI Asia Taipei Expo, a game-oriented trade fair that targets the needs of exporters. Touch Taiwan, a global leading trade show for displays. SecuTech, Asia's ultimate business and technology platform for security, IoT, and AI. Computex, the world-leading ICT trade show to build global technology ecosystems. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this will wrap up our webinar today. We appreciate you being here with us. We hope this session was helpful for your ESG journey, and please join us to become an ESG solution provider. Finally, as Taiwan gradually eases COVID restrictions, we hope to see every one of you very soon at the exhibitions. And if you like today's content, please share. Thank you, and have a nice day.
opportunity to your business and to our business to represent our product. Thank you, GTI.
Have you noticed? The rules of the world seem to have changed. An invisible treasure chest now guards your digital self. Your brainstorming partner is no longer human. It is artificial intelligence. There are no limits to your creativity. Esports is now a sport and a profession. There is a more comprehensive mind-body approach to medicine. Everywhere, from the seen to the unseen, from cities to your surroundings, technology is transforming your tomorrow, and I am the power of change. Computex.